Sam Bankman-Fried.
Wow.
Sentenced to 25 years.
Yeah.
If not 25 years. So on the wake up.
That's a fact.
25 years. But what is the big, what's the biggest lesson from this? FTX scam, whatever you want to call it, misappropriation of funds, however you want to categorize it. You know, billions of dollars gone, right? So what can we learn from this situation?
I think the biggest lesson is to be honorable, operate with integrity, and then when it comes to other people's finances, don't lie. I think he had a chance to be crypto's Buffett. And I think even if he would have been honest about some of those losses at that time, I think he would have had enough people support him and come back in where he could have raised the capital again and he would have been A-okay. But when you start lying about the number of trades you're taking, how well you're doing, I think this year and next would be like the year of integrity. And those who were doing nefarious things, they'll step to the wayside. But I think the biggest lesson is just to be honorable and deliver on what you're supposed to do. And that's it. And eventually, no matter how good the scheme may seem, when we saw this with Madoff as well, no matter how magical the returns may seem, if it's not true, it's going to get revealed. Going back to that quote, my dad, a lie is only good so the truth shows up. You can't finagle people forever and think you're going to get away with it. So for all of my traders, investors, if you haven't had your moment yet, continue to work on your craft. And even from this standpoint, imagine how much money he could have made if he was actually giving those returns out. In crypto, it's easy to do 30% in a quarter. Like, if he would have hit those marks, seeing what the value of, like, the BlackRock ETF, BlackRock may not have had room to even have the ETF. It would have went through him. So operate with integrity, be the best at your craft, and then all the riches will come from there, but you can't shortcut your way there. But what do you guys think is the biggest lesson?
I don't know. Is this one of these, you know, we talk about casino all the time, like, and Jay says that famous line, should have stayed in food and beverage. When you had something that was working before it became obviously what it ended up being with millions of people being defrauded, the greed, the arrogance all plays into it, right? When you start doing things that are uncommon to your lane, right? They started naming NBA arenas, right? You started seeing more commercials. Had he stayed at the fundamental discipline of what he was intended to do, it doesn't look like this.
Yeah.
But you take into account the age of the person, right? What I mean, how do you respond when you're up billions of dollars and you haven't hit 30 yet?
Mm-hmm.
Right? It's tough to really try to conceptualize that because how many people that we know get into that position? But even the team around him, right? Like, I think that's a valuable lesson too, right? The first people, once things were going wrong, they knew it was wrong, right?
Yeah.
And it was just a matter of time before they cracked. I think, you know, obviously Carolyn Ellison, who was his girlfriend at the time, was the person who actually blew the whistle, pled guilty to a bunch of charges and took a lesser charge. But
yeah,
at that point, like, you know what's wrong from the beginning, right?
Absolutely.
I guess we can call it American greed, but this is greed, age, arrogance, and not staying in your lane. I think all those things coming together at once, this is how it plays out. Now 25 years is what he's faced with, which is, Is it steep enough?
Nah, 25 is different, bro.
Even my guy Drew said it. He like, I remember, shout out to Drew, he like, I remember when white collar crime was 5 to 10 years.
Yeah, 25.
25 off the rip, they wanted 47 years.
We're talking about 29 billion.
25 different, bro.
29 billion?
I agree, but also too hypothetically, if I ran a hedge fund,
yeah,
and I wanted to now be the safety zone for crypto, throw the book at him, make him the fall guy, and then I come out with an ETF as a signal of safety. Once again, I can't come into the media space and say, I'm going to take everything over from everyone. At some point, HBO Max or Netflix, somebody's going to get mad. Even when I go on my little rants about who I may not like, or Adam 22, I'll pick someone who can't topple my career. Though he was gunning at all the banks, all the institutions, and everyone in crypto.
That's the arrogance.
That's the air. You can't shoot at everybody and expect no one to shoot back.
Yeah, I mean, they thought he was gonna get six.
6 years?
Yeah, they thought, well, his team, his lawyers thought that they were shooting for 6 years. When the judge,
sure they'll appeal.
They'll appeal. I'm sure they're going to appeal. When the judge, yeah. I mean, when I read the transcript, all he kept saying was all he could hear was Carolyn Ellison's recant the stories of how they knew it was wrong. They knew it was wrong. And ultimately, him listening to her testify is what made him give him that sentence of 25 years.
Yeah, 25 years different, bro. I don't know how
to. I'm not wishing that on anybody.
You said.
I don't know if it's enough. I'm asking. No, I don't know. The victims of it will probably say maybe it's not. I don't know.
Supposed to get life in jail for stealing money?
How much time?
What made of God?
That's more time than a murder.
What made of God?
But he was 90 years old anyway.
He wasn't 90 when he got arrested.
How old was he?
He was in his 60s.
When he get? No, he wasn't. No, he was.
Google he had to be 60. Madoff got 150 years.
But I thought it was 180.
How old was he when he got arrested? Ask ChatGPT how old he was.
I'm going to right now.
In the meantime, well, put it in chat. How much time do you think is appropriate for him to get for embezzlement?
He's 71.
71 when he got arrested?
71. So it's like no matter what you give him, it's
about the award anyway, right?
Yeah, you give him 10 years, it's a life sentence.
They gave him 150, though. That's crazy.
But he died in jail before 10, like at least
11. He died 10 years after.
Yeah. So whatever you gave him, he was going to die in jail. But I'm just saying, you give somebody that's 30 years old.
If it was $29 billion loss a year per billion, they couldn't give him six. They could not. Like his legal team, you're delusional. You're going to end up on a Boeing plane if you get that boy 6 years. Like you can't have this kind of going into an election. A person who took that much money, you're going to give him 6 years and let him go back to the Bahamas and hang out with Andrew Schultz and Duvall? Nah.
What do you think she gets sentenced to? Right, his co-defendant. She pled guilty to 2 counts of wire fraud, 2 counts of conspiracy to commit wire fraud, conspiracy to commit commodities fraud, conspiracies to commit securities fraud, and conspiracy to commit money laundering. What do you think she gets for cooperating?
She may get 7.
7?
Yeah.
What you think?
I mean, if she cooperated, then she probably...
Yeah, she made the case.
Yeah.
He went for Tekashi.
What's the point of ratting if you're going... Go to jail.
Do 20 with them. Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
It's a lot.
Yeah. I think mastery of crafts. Can we agree there's no shortcuts? I mean, even like when I be like doing my review videos in like the media space, I'll see some views spike up to 900,000, but it's like you got 3,000 followers. Like there's no shortcut. If he would have just focused on trading less, even an arbitrage play when he was like, I was buying Bitcoin in Asia and then swapping it over to the United States. Like he didn't have to do all that lying. He could have just been a crypto darling just off getting 30% return a quarter. That's still beating all the ETFs and indexes. And with the rate Bitcoin was running,
yeah,
the gains were already baked in.
Yeah, but he when the ceiling crashed in is when obviously Bitcoin pulled back.
Yeah.
Right. It wasn't when it was on this run to 70, which I mean, if the timing was different, who knows if he's even stopped, right?
Yeah.
But Bitcoin pulled back. You know how this goes. When everything crashes, people are like, where's the money?
But if he's trading, he should have been able to at least short because the future was available. So he should have been at least hedge or short and make up. But I think sometimes no matter how much money you have, when you try and dig yourself out of a loss and you don't know how many trades you're going to take per year. And I know people hate when I give that advice, but I'm like, it's the same with a casino. Like they know if you trade more than 100 times in a year, that's going to be in their favor. They're going to eat you up on fees. Great. But the losses are going to mount up and they know that you trade more once you get into a hole as well. So I think it's just a great exercise. And like nothing is new under the sun. Every fund is went under for the same reason, overtrading, being arrogant, having too high of a percentage gain that you want to get clients, like just stay in a sweet spot, get in and get out, be consistent. But even in all of these fallouts, BlackRock is the greatest benefiter of him going to jail.